All right, let's talk about something that stops a ton of would-be app creators right in their tracks. The big question, do you absolutely, positively need a MacBook to build an app for an iPhone? So you've got this amazing idea, right? The drive is there, the vision is crystal clear, but then bam, you hit that infamous Apple wall and you start thinking that the price of that shiny laptop is the price of your dream. You know, for the longest time, the MacBook was like the one and only key to get into Apple's exclusive app development club. It was non-negotiable. So let's dig into why that was the case, and more importantly, how that's all changing. But here's the thing. What if I told you that old role is, well, it's broken? The game has totally changed. We're going to explore exactly how, and why the answer to that big question is, finally, a resounding no. Okay, so first things first. To really get why the Mac was such a big deal, you have to understand Apple's whole philosophy. You've probably heard the term, the walled garden. I mean, Apple's control over its hardware and software is, it's legendary, right? And look, that tight grip is why the apps on your iPhone are so secure and just work so well. But that same control, well, it built a pretty high wall for any developer who wasn't already inside. Right? So because of that walled garden, for years and years, the MacBook wasn't just a nice to have, it was essential. And honestly, there are still some really powerful reasons why it's considered the gold standard, the best way to do it if you can. And the heart of it all is this thing called Xcode. Seriously, think of it as the command center, the entire toolkit for building iOS apps. And in a classic Apple move, they keep it locked down. It only runs on macOS. And when you're developing on a Mac, everything just clicks. It all works together seamlessly. Your code, iCloud, the App Store submission process, it's all one smooth workflow. And let me tell you, that's a huge advantage. It saves you so many headaches. This is what we call the home field advantage. I mean, testing your app is absolutely critical, and the simulator you get right inside Xcode, it's just flat out faster and more accurate than anything else out there, period. So yeah, the bottom line is, using a Mac is the smoothest, most direct, Apple-approved way to get from an idea to the App Store. It just is. But, and this is a big but, it's not the only way anymore. Okay, so how did this all change? What happened? Well, thanks to some really smart new tools and, frankly, a different way of thinking, those high walls around the garden, they've started to get some gates. I love this quote from our source material because it just hits the nail on the head. The entire landscape has shifted. The old rules, they just don't apply like they used to. So this is the big question, right? If you're sitting there with a Windows PC or a Chromebook, what are your options? How do you actually get your app onto an iPhone? Well, it turns out there are three really solid ways to do it now. All right, let's break them down. Path one is renting a Mac in the cloud. Path two is using what are called cross-platform frameworks. And path three, honestly, the biggest game changer of them all, is the no-code revolution. Okay, so this first path is actually pretty smart. You're basically renting a real Mac that's sitting in a data center somewhere. You just log into it over the internet. This is a fantastic option if you only need macOS for a short time, like just for that final testing phase or to submit the app without having to buy the whole machine. Now, path number two is all about working smarter, not harder. You use tools that let you write your code just one time, and it'll work on both iOS and Android. It's super efficient. But here's the catch, and it's an important one. You might still need to get on a Mac for a few minutes just for that final step of publishing to the App Store. Okay, a quick but important warning. You might hear about something called a hackintosh, which is basically running macOS on a regular PC. We're mentioning this only to tell you, don't do it. It violates Apple's rules, it's unstable, and it's just not a good idea for any serious project. And that brings us to path number three. And honestly, this one is the biggest deal of them all. We're talking about the no-code revolution. This changes everything. So what is no-code? Well, it's exactly what it sounds like. These are platforms that let you build real, powerful apps without writing a single line of code. You use these super intuitive drag-and-drop dashboards right in your web browser. All the complicated technical stuff, the platform just handles it for you. And this is the real magic of it. It means you don't need Xcode. You don't need to know how to code. And you absolutely do not need a Mac. The platform takes care of the whole shebang, from building the app to getting it onto the App Store. So let's just pull this all together. You can see it laid out here. The classic MacBook route? Yeah, it's the smoothest experience for sure, but the upfront cost is high and you gotta have the technical skills. Then you look at the alternatives, like Cloud Macs or cross-platform tools, and especially no-code, and you can see how they just completely knock down those barriers of cost and skill. And really, that's the big takeaway here. Accessibility has finally arrived. That huge price tag and the platform restrictions, they're just not the showstoppers they used to be for your big idea.
You know, the keys to Apple's kingdom are pretty much available to everyone now. So the real question is, what are you going to build? It's a whole new world for creators out there. Thanks for joining this explainer, and we'll catch you on the next one.